Okay? Is it going to be okay? All right? First thing I'll say is, unfortunately, Matt Pucci has got COVID. And he can't come. I even bought a guitar, an extra guitar stand for him. But I'm sorry to say that he can't make it because he got COVID. Classic. What a classic. Gosh, it's kicking upstairs, isn't it? Remember when you used to make that kind of noise? Remember when your idea of fun was going into a bar, drinking six pints of lager, not hearing a single word that anybody else said, and shouting back at them? Those were the days.
Still is. Hey, still doing it.
Apparently it's exactly the same date.
Yeah.
As 4 years ago.
Yeah, on my Facebook.
How weird is that?
Yes, it is. The
Betsy Trotwood. Yeah. Betsy Trotwood, yeah.
That must mean something.
It means I'm 4 years older.
And no wiser.
Very true.
And we still haven't managed to learn Whiskey in the Jar, you know. All those verses in that weird Irish bloody language. Okay, are you ready? I think we're going to start off with the same song as 4 years ago, just to remind you that you were here. That you were here then. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thank you. rich man's town, hot in Botany Bay. Prisoner of my own device, mountain in my way. Gonna have to alter my address. From the catalogue of history, from Uninvited Like the Clouds. She'll come back for you tomorrow. Okay, you ready? It grants you wishes and takes them all away. And it pushes and it squeezes. It breaks the spirit, kills the soul. And it does just as it pleases. It digs your heart in to the you follow. Yeah, we need a harp, yeah. That's right. We need a harp. We have a friend who plays the harp, actually, and if she was didn't live in Joshua Tree, she might be here with us tonight. This is a song from some record sometime made, you know. It's been a long, long road, hasn't it? in the US, if you know. The bully matter was a girl from Argentina. And you're reading Le Monde in record time. And you can't decide which entree as you peruse the menu. So you sell the avocado lime. Then you're sitting in your sports car with your number plate from Monaco, and you're heading down the coast to catch a fly. And you wake up in the hospital with your face unrecognizable, and the nurse just comes and she switches off the light. She switches off the light. Ah, ah, the light. The light comes on to warn ya. You better have a life. You gotta feed your mind. You gotta feed your mind. Decided we haven't got any record out or anything, but we started to do some kind of, after 4 years of being here, some kind of career retrospective. So we're going to do a couple of songs off records that we haven't played songs from ever before. So please be kind if we fuck it up. Right. So this is off the second Moat record, Poison Stream, which everybody goes, what's that? And we have never played a song from it, so nobody actually ever knows what that actually is. It's a collaboration with a guy from, he's German-Swedish, lives in Stockholm, plays in an amazingly huge Swedish band called Weeping Willows. His name is Nico. He does a lot of song, film composing, but he doesn't write words or sing, so he gives me stuff and I write words and sing on it. And he does a lot of the guitars as well, actually, because he plays the guitar and the keyboards and the pedal steel and the bass and the piano. He's just kind of a talented musician. So between the two of us, we came up with the Moat project. And Moat actually stands for something. You know, M-O-A-T. What?
Go on, tell us.
No. I'm sure you've come up with your own idea. Something rude, no doubt.
Is there a reward if someone gets it?
Yeah, there's a reward if someone gets it.
English or Swedish?
Is it in English or in Swedish?
Yeah.
Well, good question. Somebody's really going to try and do this.
Can we ask Marlon?
It's in English. But if you come up with something in Swedish, you might get the reward anyway. Anyway, it's called Helpless You. I think it's about a sad vampire who finally gets sick of himself and bites himself to death or something. Et voilà. But I was thinking of going for Brian Johnson's job when they got Axel. Remember that? They got Axel because Brian Johnson couldn't do it because he was going deaf. Surprise, surprise. Angus must have some kind of padded school uniform that stops, I don't know. Help us, you. Now and do a very sort of quiet, sensitive song. This is a song I wrote all in one go. Lyrics, music, chords, melody, arrangement, to a cassette without thinking about anything. Didn't write anything down, just jammed it to a cassette, then copied it onto a record, and that was the song. Sometimes it goes like that. You could be in Guns N' Roses and spend 16 years making one album, it'd be a load of rubbish. You could do it that way. But there's other ways. This is called I Don't Think So.
Thank you.
who introduced me to that gorgeous man there. And we hung out for a bit, and then we sort of started going out. After about 3 months, she said, "Do you want to go to Australia?" And I went, "All right." And so I married her, got on a plane, went to Australia in April. By April, May, July, I was in the church. October, we released a single. It was a bit of a hit. And then an album came out, and we had a big hit with The Unguarded Moment. The problem with that story is, I could have been Will Sargent if I'd stayed in Liverpool. Think about that for a moment. Where can is Ian McCulloch's translator? It's
great. Where's my childhood?
You what? Yeah, have you, I don't know if you've ever seen the Bunny Man in America, but you know nobody understands a single word that he says. It's classic. He goes up to the microphone and he goes, he's next to someone who's now kill the moon. It's like nobody understands a single word that he says. But we were doing a record in Liverpool with Wild Swans. There's a new Wild Swans record, I'm playing guitar on it. We started it, it's not finished yet. But Paul Simpson, the singer, you know, he used to be in the Teardrop Explodes, play keyboards and Teardrop Explodes, and then he's formed the Wild Swans. He was in Care with, you know, Lightning Seeds guy. Ian Brody, yeah. And the engineer was from Liverpool, there was me, and there was Paul, and there was Edgar, who was playing bass, who was in The Stairs. The Stairs?
Yeah. The Summertime, yeah.
Right, okay. I'm telling you, none of us could understand anything he said. So anyway, this is Strachach from Records. It's probably one of the best things we've ever heard in your life, because I've been playing like before, and I hope you really like it. So after that, making that first album, 1982, Bob Clearmountain mixed the first album.
Wow.
Next album, he came to Australia, and he was the nicest man ever. He had absolutely no ego. He came in and he said, "Oh, I've just got this mix of Flesh and Blood by Roxy Music." And he just mixed Tattoo You. Had no ego at all. He came in, the studios these days, well, in those days, for many years, they've had NS10M Yamaha speakers. He was the guy that started it. He came in the studio, brought these speakers with him, put them on the mixing desk, got a piece of tissue paper and put it over the tweeter. He said, "That's the sound." Didn't say much. But when he came back into the control room and heard what it sounded like, that's why the Blue Crusade is such a fantastic sounding record. Yeah. This is a song from that record which nobody ever does anymore because it's too hard. You know, who's going to learn the solo on violin? Hello.
Hello. I've been here the whole time.
Yes, we know. This is almost with you, believe it or not. Which bind men with. I'm almost with you. I can sense it wait for me. I'm almost with you. Is this the taste I think to me? I'm almost with you. You see the dust which fills your sleep. Does it always feel this chill in the air? I never dreamed we'd meet here once more. This life's reason for a friend. Who you trying to get in touch with? Who you trying to get in touch with? Who you trying to get in touch with? I'm lost with you. I can sense it wait for me. I'm almost with you. Is this the taste of victory? I'm almost with you. I have it is because it's tuned down to D, because when I was 25 I could reach any note but not anymore. So we do kind of, I think everybody does it when they get, even Sting can't reach the high notes anymore. So, and Scrim, who's sitting there, where's he gone?
Loo.
Oh, he's gone the loo. Oh, I was going to talk about him, and he's gone the loo. Isn't that classic?
Talk about what?
Oh, my God. Because Scrim is the luthier who used to do agitas, and he set this one up for me, you know, completely set it up, redid it all, and made it so it plays in D without being a disaster. And he always puts a little note on. Right? And I never take them off. You know, you're supposed to go, tune to D, right? Boom. But I never take them off. He's not here to hear this. Classic. Guess he doesn't really care, though.
Oh, shit, should that be working?
There you go. Thanks, Q. God, he must have had a few pints. So early in the night. Anyway, so this is a song very topical, I suppose. This is from the first Nocturum album, which is the first album I did with my old friend Dare Mason. And this is a song from that first Sparks Lane album. It's called Sparks Lane because that was the road that connected our houses between my parents' house and his parents' house. His Heron's house. And so that's why, and there's no apostrophe for people who think it's missing. queen of grammar sits beside me. Anything you want to know about English, ask my German friend. So here he is, Scrim. I was just saying, Scrim, every time you fix all the guitars up, you always put a little note on them, right? And it says, right, tuned to D. But I always leave them on. They remind me of you. I still think he's very impressed, actually. Anyway, so this is a very topical. Wrote it a long time ago, 2000, I think it was. But it's, I mean, I guess it was relevant even then. So here we go, him. Not t-shirt weather.
Yet.
Yet. Very soon you're going to be wishing you had a Marley and Olivia t-shirt.
18 to go.
18 to go. To break even. We sold none in Penzance, one in Bristol, and one tonight so far. 18 to go, and you all look very, very sexy, I'm sure. Marley and Olivia t-shirt. Okay, so this is last song for this little first set, and it is from, what album is it from, Olivia? Yeah. Rhyme, is it? Rhyme? So I'm Rhyme, to where I am now. And if any of you read my blog, my insane blog that I've written every day for 1,153 days. Sorry, 55. 1,155 days in a row. That's insane, isn't it? I must like it. That's what it is. I must like doing it. I like doing it. That's the thing. All that time I could have written like 5 albums worth of. But no. Anyway, it's to where I am though.
Here I am now.
people's attention, that people's attention, that one, always. In and around the lake, mountains climb out of the sky, they stop down. Somebody here must know that song.
No. Yeah, it's the right answer.
Not that anything has been chronological, but in 1984, it was decided that we would make the third EP. There was Sings, there was the two, there was Tear It All Away EP, Too Fast For You, remember that?
Yeah.
And there was Biggles, see this man here? He was responsible for temperature drop in downtown Winterland. He, single-handedly, was responsible for that. And then there was Sing Songs.
Yes.
And there was Persia. And there was Remote Luxury. And those were the days when you could sell a 12-inch piece of vinyl and with five tracks on it, and people would buy that. You know, those were the days when you could sell records. You could never imagine that people would prefer things that sounded worse, would you? You could never have imagined that would was what would happen. It's like a plane that doesn't fly properly. Oh, that's better. Well, it's the same with cars, isn't it? Cars that don't go probably fall apart. Or remember my iPods?
Yeah.
You know? My mobile phone that doesn't even that last anymore. But if you bought a Morgan in 1962, you've probably still got it.
It's quite useful.
Yeah. Hang on, I'm just having a Genesis moment. Alright, okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
You're not feeling nervous this second set?
No.
No, you're okay? You're going to be alright?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Don't worry. Everything's going to be fine. You'll be okay. You'll get through it. Into my hands. 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
back to Winterland. I take loving to my hands, journey back to Winterland. That's what I call speed folk.
Yeah.
We made, years have gone by, haven't they? David Lindley died.
Oh, yeah.
David Lindley. Now, David Lindley played on Starfish. Yeah, he played on... What song was it?
Antenna,
thank you. He played on Antenna. He was a lovely man. He had this long sort of curly hair, and whenever he spoke to you, he always spoke to you in a Jamaican accent. Because he was a total stoner. But he was a great guy, he was really friendly. Sad, isn't it? Did anybody ever hear his band Kaleidoscope?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a kind of a forgotten treasure, isn't it? Well, if you come to the Indie Music Archive, you can hear it in there. The what? The Indie Music Archive. What's that, Marty? You've never heard of it?
No.
Really? Where you been, baby? So we have premises now in Portugal, where we moved to. And 2,500 square feet. We've got enough space for the archive and a little studio in there. And the plan is to bring it over as soon as we sort out the bleeding customs. Because of Brexit, there's a 23% tax charge on the value of the goods. Hello. So we've got a letter from the mayor's assistant in Portugal saying that it's a cultural event. Right, which is true, and we're hoping to bring it into Portugal without all the costs, but now at least we've got a premises, so we'll probably do some kind of fundraiser for it, just to help with two articulated trucks full of records. You know, it's going to cost, God knows how much, we'll find out.
And anyway, there's going to be a big opening party in Portugal.
Big opening party. Yeah. Free pastel de natas.
We're all invited.
You'll be there.
Okay, so here we go. This is a song from the Art Attack album, which we made in, Dare and I made in management's office. We had to do it in office hours because the building closed at 5 o'clock. Making a record in office hours is the weirdest thing ever. But that's what we did with this, trying to, you know, it's like that, Billy Bragg stole the idea from Vladimir Mayakovsky. Well, you all know who Vladimir Mayakovsky is. Talking to the tax man about poetry. You know that?
Yeah.
From Billy Bragg. Yes, some of you do. Well, Billy Bragg stole that from the Russian suicidal poet Vladimir Mayakovsky. And making a record in an office is like talking to the tax man about poetry. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. You smooth. tortured neck and the trapped curving tongue. Your cage of a mouth springs open and throws out the seeds of song. The grown flower now after our blessed velvet. In Italy. I always leave a gap after saying that. I was playing football with Ian Asprey. And he said to me, baby, 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 pass the ball. And I used to love his hair. He had the best hair. Not a bad singer either.
Better.
I actually bought their new album. Did anybody buy that? No. It's good. It's the best album in a long time. Anyway, I bought it, so there you go. So we had a day off, and we went to Venice for a day. And I wrote this song inspired by being in Venice. One other thing, when we came to, back to the gig, we did the sound check. They opened the doors half an hour early, and in walked a troop of soldiers carrying machine guns. Italy, you know. Italy, yeah, Corrado. Corrado's Italian. And where is she?
Anna.
Oh, right. She's Italian as well. Anyway, so she, they know about machine guns in Italy with the police, right? Because goths and people who like metal music are the most dangerous people in the world. Those guys in the suits with the nice hair and the ties, they're just... You can trust them. But those goths and metal freaks, danger to society. They need machine guns to control them. Anyway, welcome to the 18th century, as it is in Italy sometimes, right? Water. Thank you. 8 sound in tune to you?
Yeah.
The problem is with the 12th string, one's a little bit flat and the other one's a little bit sharp. It's like, whoa! Not anymore. Album that could have been if we had the drums done properly and we'd spelt Pharaoh correctly. Could have made all the difference. But this is the one we were going to do with Matt Pucci from the Rain Parade. This is the one. We recorded it and sent him an 8-minute copy of it.
Yeah.
And he was coming here tonight to play with us on this song. But for those of you who didn't hear earlier, he got COVID and had to cancel.
Oh.
So, yeah. So that's pretty sad. So this is for Matt. This is for Matt. Get better soon, dude. He's a good man. He's a really good man. He's, last time I played with him was in San Francisco, and he's just a great guy. We played with him, I guess, though, in the early 80s as well, somewhere in California. Like when they just made that first album, somewhere around there. Emergency Third Rail Power Trip. Title of the year. Yeah. I don't know what I'm going to do about that. What do you think I should do about that? People keep on asking me, what's this all about? I'd just like to start off by telling you I bought this guitar new. It was brand new when I bought it. Right? And the reason it's like that is because Sorry, what were we talking about? We were?
Did roadies do that?
Do what? I don't know what anybody's talking about anymore. You don't want to know why, it's just not interesting. Okay, here we go. Charge on your mind. The glittering feelings not far behind. Sadly, witness amongst these shades we've got to grind. Actually, that grind is a song that Ian Astbury could sing. Yeah. Isn't it? It's really in his. Well, we like to keep things eclectic and we like to keep things. Keep you on your toes. That was great about the Beatles. All kinds of different kinds of songs. All kinds of different sounds. Four vocalists in the band. Left-handed drummer playing right-handed. Left-handed bass player. We went on the Beatles tour in Liverpool, and I don't know if you know this, but the poshest one was definitely John. He was so the poshest one. He saw Ringo's house. It's like Ringo was like, whoa, outside toilet, you know? And George was like, two up, two down. Paul was kind of a little bit up, but John was like, ooh, semi-detached, you know. Yeah, tragic. This is a song, another thing that we don't usually do, is a song from the first Moat album. We made 1,000 copies, and we have like 9 left. In the or less in the world. So if you care about things like that, this is your chance. And by the way, don't forget to pick me up a packet of cigarettes. Sometimes I get in trouble. This is a song which is kind of completely different to the last one, and that's good. This is from the first Mo album. It's called Felice. with freaks and tans. Need a maniac in the cul-de-sac. Otherwise, it's this ennui. As a career retrospective, which would be impossible to do, we thought we'd just do a couple of songs by a couple of the other bands that I've been in. First we're going to start with a Judas Priest song. You'd love it if I did a Judas Priest song, wouldn't you? You didn't know I was in Judas Priest, did you? I saw Judas Priest in the 70s in Liverpool at St George's Hall supporting Budgie. Yeah. Wow. Supporting Budgie. And everybody thought it was really weird because Rob Halford had short hair. Nobody had short hair except him. And you know where that led him? You know where that led him? Studs. I meant studs. Breaking the law. You'd love it if I did that. I should learn it, shouldn't I? I should do a reggae version of it.
Hip-hop version.
I like this idea of putting images in your heads and then you imagining things beyond it, you know?
Then you don't do it.
That's right. Then I don't do it. That's right. Does anyone hear a joke? Shit, Trevor, what is it?
Open the window.
A musician goes to the doctors and the doctor says, "I'm sorry, you've only got 6 months to live." The musician says, "On what?"
That's good.
That's good, right?
Anyway,
there you go. Keep it light. Start taking it seriously. Start, you know, something weird starts happening. Start getting wrinkles. Okay, so after I left Judas Priest, I taught K.K. Downing everything he knows. K.K. Downing, his name's Ken, isn't it? He talks like that. His name's Ken. But if you think Ken from Birmingham versus K.K. Downing, it's just like a whole, it's amazing what image. It's like J.K. Rowling. It just kind of sounds like, you know, important. So I joined All About Eve for 10 years. And we did two albums. The one that sold the worst was the best. And a lot of people really love that album, the second album, Ultraviolet. But the on the first album, we had this single which got in the top 40. But at the time, I was in Australia doing something with the church, and I was not able to appear on Top of the Pops. Oh. Right? And Adam, our stage roadie, went and pretended he was playing my guitar parts, which is pretty impressive because there's some tricky little moments even to mime. So we're going to try and do those tricky little moments here for you tonight and together. Okay, Farewell Mr. Sorrow, obviously. 2, 3, 4. was that on? Was it on Ultraviolet? Was it on Touch by Jesus?
Yes.
Touch by Jesus. Yeah. Touch now. Bloody hell, what's the matter with ya? Okay, so I also played with the Saints. Yeah, I made an album with them called Nothing Is Straight in My House, which was Chris Bailey's sense of humour, of course. And he was like the greatest singer I ever worked with. Amazing voice, just completely original. Fantastic singer, crazy guy. They used to call him the Oscar Wilde of Australia. One of the first punk bands. So as soon as punk became hip and cool, what did Chris do? Grew his hair. He just did not want to be part of the whole cool side of punk. And paid for it consequently because, you know, three albums, the punk thing was dying, but he continued making records, and he started making more melodic records because he was a great songwriter. Bruce Springsteen did one of his songs. Do you know the song? Just like firewood, I burn. No, okay. Anyway, Just Like Firewood was a Chris Bailey song that Bruce Springsteen covered. That's pretty cool. Charlie Sexton covered one of my songs. Not quite Bruce Springsteen, I know. But Charlie Sexton's Bob Dylan's guitarist. So, that's cool. Tangent. So, I thought what we'd do, we'd try and do a little medley of Chris Bailey and the Saints songs. Well, just two, actually. I think...
It's a perfect day.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a perfect day. What about the way they started incorporating brass into the songs? Yeah. It was just amazing. It was such a great... Did you ever hear the song you did with Nick Cave?
Yes.
Yeah, bring it on. Anyway, he had a fantastic voice. I was lucky enough to write one of the songs with him on that album. So... Sadly, Chris died last year, and so this is for him if he's listening up in. This is for Chris if he's listening up in hell. Always.
Yeah.
And ghost ships.
Yes. Yes.
Right. Yeah, yeah. Here we go. Don't go to wait until tomorrow, and then we'll see. I don't know about tomorrow. Wish that today could last forever. I'm standing on the edge of a lonely sea. Here comes the night and brings the sorrow. I will stay waiting for tomorrow. Always, always, always. I don't know what you would find. Anyway, Off of the Light is coming out record store day. This is one of our favourite songs to play live, and we're going to finish with it tonight. Hopes and Fears. Hope you like it. 'Cause it's here, it's where the air is clear, the far off things can be quite near.
Thank you.